things that we need to be very cognitive of. They talk about voter ID. Do you know what that's all about? They talk about voter ID is suppressing the vote. And the way that came about in Louisiana, especially in New Orleans, the majority of African Americans rode the bus. So if you went to the polls to vote, you had no ID. They were trying to suppress the black vote. We have to understand the games that are being played. You know, right after Reconstruction, that was one of the most progressive periods in our history, getting elected. Then we had this movie come out, Birth of the Next Nation. They depicted black folks in elected office with the feet up on a table as scoundrels, as rapists. You know, so every time we go forward, they try to knock us back. If we don't know our history, ladies and gentlemen, how in the world can we address these things? We can't tolerate this thing they call apathy, complacency, saying let somebody else do it for us. So in this state here of New Mexico, you know, whether we talk about the numbers game, but we need to get engaged. And as you go and look at the politicians that are running, you know, they're looking for volunteers. They're looking for people to do phone banking. The thing that we're going to be looking at is GOTV, get the vote out on election day and before election day, because they got early voting now. So people can start voting early. They got absentee ballot now. So all of these things have an impact. So we have to understand what this is all about. We can sit at home and they can promulgate these policies and procedures. They're affecting our lives every day. They're affecting our lives every day. So I just encourage each and every one of you that, you know, it's not about the numbers, but the numbers that we have to get the numbers out. And if you get on the phone, you call 5 people, call 10 people, tell them how important it is that they get out and vote in this election. And caveat emptor, buyer beware. They're trying to sell us a bill of goods. You know, if you listen to what the president told black folks, he said, well, that party over there hadn't done anything for you. And then as soon as he get in there, he slapped them in the face. He went across down all those people that he promised he was going to do certain things, kicking certain folks out of the military. You know, but he told them, look here, I love you, I'm running. So you get these false promises. And so we have to become more astute. We have to become more aware. We have to understand what's at stake. You know, jobs is at stake. Housing is at stake. You know, it used to be in the South Broadway area, we had a concentration of all the black churches. Every politician went down to the South Broadway area, Reverend Cox, before Pastor Hill. When I first got out of college, he said, I know all of the judges. I know all of the elected officials. They've been down here to ask for my help and my support. They used to do that. We didn't have to go to them. They came to our community. But we have sprinkled all over the city now. We're not concentrated in one area. So there's this divide and conquer. So if they can keep us confused, if they can keep us where we don't understand, we're not talking to each other, we're not communicating, we're not collaborating, we're not cooperating, then those are the types of things that they might need. And with the sophistication, they get these voter registration rolls. They know who voted, when they voted. And so when you go say, okay, well, we turned it out in masses, they go look at these numbers and they know that we did not. So I just really want to thank when Pastor Smith talked about a blue wave. We have to not only reverse what I call this crab syndrome. The crab is when we're reaching up and pulling each other down. We need to reverse that and pull up. And so this is what the blue wave is all about. We need to teach one another exactly what politics is all about. We think it's a dirty word, but politics is really what runs this country. It's running the whole world. So last but not least, let me just say that if there's anything I can do in a commercial on behalf of the mayor, we got to hire 100 police officers this year. We got another 100 next year. We got 100 the year after that. And another 100 the year after that. So we're looking at about 400 police. If our kids are not ready today, let's start getting them prepared. And we talk about diversity, and I mentioned earlier, if we don't apply, how can they hire us? We go and ask the mayor, how many did you hire? We go ask the governor, how many state police did you have? But if none of us apply, how can they hire us? So I'm going to be working with all the churches saying, we need your help. We need to do some recruiting. And it's not only the police position, but they'll have other positions. So as we look across this board, we need to be a part of, because if you look at all the parishioners in the church, if these people have decent jobs, this thing where they can contribute to the church. So those are the types of things that can have a tremendous impact. So again, I wanted to say God bless each and every one of you. And again, thank you for all the years that you've given me support. But I'm saying the battle is not over. This battle is the rest of my life, the rest of maybe my kid's life and our kid's kid's life. The door is just cracked. It is not open. So we need to work to open up that door. So thank you very much for having me.